Here we go.
First of all, what are chloroplasts? Well, chloroplasts are organelles that can only be found in a plant cell. Organelles are, of course, the special structures in the working area of every cell. Chloroplasts are the organelles that produce food through the process of photosynthesis. On the other hand, animal cells do not require photosynthesis as they rely on ready-made food. Chloroplasts reproduce by the process of cell division. Although they are very small organelles, they can be seen with the use of a light microscope. They are the reason why plants are green, because chloroplasts contain the chemical chlorophyll. Every single plant, being autotrophic, converts energy from the sun into sugars and glucose. All organisms rely on plants for energy, as plants are the only kind of organisms that can create their own food. The process of photosynthesis takes place in the chloroplast, therefore making chloroplasts a vital link in life on Earth. Before we jump into the structure of chloroplasts themselves, we should first find where they are located. In fact, since they are found in plant cells, it would be wise to explore the parts of a plant cell first. The main parts of the cell are the nucleus, the cell wall, the cytoplasm, the vacuole, the mitochondria, and finally the chloroplast, which we will explore further. What you are looking at now is a cross-sectional view of a chloroplast. We will briefly explore the main six parts of this vital structure. The first two parts are the outer membrane and the inner membrane. These are the parts of the chloroplast that protect the inside. The two membranes are folded together to create a stack of flattened discs, which act as a very good protective mechanism. Thylakoids are membranes in which the reactions involving light and sun energy take place. These thylakoids are embedded into the stroma. A stack of thylakoids is therefore called a granum. On the surface of these thylakoids are chlorophyll molecules which use sunlight to create glucose. These thylakoids are bound compartments called lumen. There you have it, the six basic parts of a chloroplast. Knowing this basic structure will help us to better understand the complex function of the chloroplast, which we will now explore. Finally, we've reached the part where we explore what chloroplasts actually do. You've probably heard the word photosynthesis used before in relation to plants, and you'd therefore be correct in guessing that it has something to do with chloroplasts. Chloroplasts contain an important chemical in them called chlorophyll, which is the reason that plants are green. This chemical is responsible for the absorption of sunlight to produce glucose. In the chloroplasts, chemical reactions occur for this purpose. It's through the process of photosynthesis that a plant cell creates glucose and oxygen. When sunlight hits a chloroplast, the chlorophyll in it absorbs the energy and in combination with carbon dioxide and water forms sugar and oxygen, hence the equation of photosynthesis which you can currently see. The outer membrane of the chloroplast contains porins which absorb sunlight. The first part of the photosynthetic process is called the light reaction and occurs in the thylakoids, which traps the light. After this, the photosynthetic process moves out to the stroma. The stroma contains a number of metabolic enzymes which are responsible for forming glucose from carbon dioxide during the process of photosynthesis. They utilize the carbon atoms from carbon dioxide and combine it with hydrogen and oxygen to make simple glucose molecules. This part of photosynthesis is called the dark reaction. This makes the final stage of photosynthesis just a series of enzyme-controlled reactions. Light is not needed to carry out this stage, but rather ATP, hence the name dark reaction. Well, there it is, the basic function of the chloroplast. Amazing how a structure just 5 to 10 micrometers long can fulfill such a complex task. So you've probably heard a lot of scientific jargon, but still asking yourself, what is the practical importance of chloroplasts in the whole scheme of things? You may have already made the connection by yourself. Chloroplasts give plants the ability to undergo photosynthesis. Of course, the product of photosynthesis is oxygen and glucose. This means that plants are able to pass around a great portion of the oxygen we breathe. Without it, there would be no life. All free oxygen on the planet, including that in the atmosphere, originates from photosynthesis. Essential sugars are also generated from the equation of photosynthesis, which animals need for survival.
This just goes to show the importance of the chloroplast function. Virtually all ecosystems on Earth rely on photosynthesis as a source of energy. Not only are they an indispensable part of life on our current Earth, but they provide a vital link to more complex life forms, which includes ourselves.